got to earn it. Butler looks to Billups. Billups against Thornton. Chauncey fires over him. Very nice.
I just thought.
And be the post-up player instead of it being Ed Davis in the post.
Tony Roten didn't play in the opener. He played in the rematch, had 8 points and 5 rebounds. Grizzlies were blown out in that one at FedEx Forum.
He's playing straight up. You don't have to foul. See, can he score from there?
There you go.
And Billups made the shot. Tap by Tony Allen won't fall.
Great scouting report knowledge by Matt Barnes to go away. Knows that Z-Bo likes to come back over that right shoulder and shoot with his left hand. Was able to bottle Z-Bo up.
Barnes, Billups, Crawford, Odom, and Grant Hill. Billups checks the clock. Double clutches. Hit another one.
Now the Clippers started the game. Of course, Chauncey Billups was playing the two slot. He's playing the one slot now. But they started the game with him doing just that, posting. And he's got an even bigger advantage height-wise on Will Bynum. So that's tough right there, George. That may have to
laugh at you. Certainly not afraid.
But not laugh at me. 71-54, Clippers have the lead. So what are you dealing with here? Billups has it near sideline against Lim.
What a game by Chauncey.
A lot of three-point shots. Good job to put the ball on the floor and get something going to the basket.
Clippers are 9-6, and they have played the fewest games in the NBA, and the Memphis Grizzlies 10-7 on the year. Right now trailing San Antonio in the Southwest Division, and a scoop by Billups off to the good start.
Big T, listen, this is our first look at the Clipper team this year, and there's a lot of hype surrounding this team. What's your first initial thoughts of this team?
Well, I think they're pretty, they're, of course they're talented, but they're
energy.
So it's 18-12. Billups. Only taking one shot. He loves the fadeaway jumper here. Turns and knocks it down.
He's tough.
Jay Ford fires for the Raptors. That won't fall. Amir Johnson with a rebound. Pistons have made just 3 of their last 20 now. After starting 7 for 13. Chauncey's got Ford in the post. Gives to Sheed. Gets it back. The turn and gun off. Glass goes.
Chauncey does play, you know, up close to the seats we sit at. He's just so calm. He just doesn't seem to have any stress in his game ever.
He's a very good post-up player. He just
off the rack to Antonio McDyess. Utah 0 for 3. The Pistons 1 out of 4. Rashid against Memo. Probably has a pretty good idea how he should be played. Can he do it? I don't know. Rashid dumps it into Chauncey. Here's a hanging turn and gun. He hit it.
And I'm really starting to like the all-around game of Jordan Farmar.
Well, Farmar, a big part of the reason the Lakers were able to beat the Pistons in L.A. back in November.
We can say that again.
Nice spin against Farmar by Chauncey, though. He wore
points and over 15 rebounds in a game this year. That is staggering.
Rashard Lewis staggering number 1 of 9. From the field here tonight, Lewis, normally a good shooter at 44%, a lot of that from long distance, just 1 of 9.
Mike, if he hit that one, that was an easy shot for him. It would have been a 15-point game. Now, Chauncey can get this shot anytime, anytime.
Stacking on Arroyo. In recent weeks, Flip Saunders has tightened his rotation quite a bit. But, of course, this is the second of a back-to-back, so we're liable to see him go a little deeper on his bench than normal. Billups backing Gordon over the top.
So Ray off to the good start, 2 for 2 with a free throw. Billups getting his first chance to try to post up Rondo, shoots over him instead and knocks it down.
That's all right.
It's this far. It'll be defense ultimately that's going to win this. They're going to have to get some stops here on Detroit.
They're going to try and work on Rondo.
They sure are. And they do.
He missed a great low post play at a four.
Guarded. Pachulia playing well off of Jason Maxfield. He becomes the option, but probably the third option on that play.
And they made it work. Chauncey against Stoudemire. 5 on the clock, now 4. He fires, he fills it up.
Elton Brand is sitting with 18 points and 10 rebounds.
Mobley got those two quick field goals, the only ones he got, right in front of us a moment ago, and now he's got a third.
He's number 15 now in the NBA overall. Only Billups is the only player on the floor better than Yao, free throw shooter. And there's Billups now trying to go to work. He'll raise up and shoot.
4 of 25. Anderson normally is a very, very good shot. From the three-point line, he's 1 of 8. Actually, 1 of 13. Billups, 9 on the shot clock. Still up and under. Difficult shot on.
8-point Bulls lead, just under 9.5 left. Up high, Rasheed Wallace. Gets it out to Prince. Now Billups with a post-up with Duhon right there. Billups, step-back jumper on the way.
Contact and being strong with it.
7 points, 2 rebounds, and assists. 3 of 3 from the field for Duhon. Prince with it. Scott Skiles talking defense to his team. He's telling everybody what to do. Billups, spin move, baseline jumper. Billups bounces it up high. Hamilton looks. Wallace inside. Again, they'll go. Billups fadeaway jumper. And he is up his third foul, got Rip Hamilton inside. First team foul either way in the third. Chauncey to the baseline. Gets it back from Rip against Kidd. Steps back, gun goes. With 15 points and 8 boards.
Hey, those guys going
and
to the side.
And 4 blocks.
And 4 blocks. Those guys going to the sideline now to feel good. They really helped the Pistons get back into this. As the starters start to make their way back out onto the court.
Chauncey turns baseline. Very,
very difficult to do against this heady defensive ball club of the Pistons. But running the floor hard and keeping the ball moving.
Magic shooters have a green light
as soon as they get into the offensive step. Billups this time is fouled.